Previously on The Lounge with Chao.
Now, you've got your boss here, one of your bosses here, William.
Yes.
Who is from Soul Generation Records. Thank you for coming.
Always a pleasure, Chao.
Okay.
Thanks for hosting us.
No worries. Please come closer to the microphone, just a little bit. Bensoul Tamonyesha.
Yeah.
He's been here a couple of times. He's like, this is how, oh, there you go. Yeah, he adjusted it. William, getting sure. When Bensoul was here the last time, he told me, and he's like, it's not yet finalized, but I'm going to be signed on to Saudi Soul.
Yeah.
What was, and then, of course, the pandemic happened, and then he got on to Saudi Soul, and then we found out, you know, during the album release, Midnight Train, which still trying to recover from that. All right. And then we had all of this great stuff has happened. Yeah. What was this process like for you as Soul Generation? Was it an easy sort of thing to say, okay, we're going to get him on board?
Right.
How did this process happen? And I'm only asking this because there are probably artists who are saying, so how do I get signed? Or do I have a possibility of being signed? And as the general manager of Soul Generation, maybe you can just give us a couple of answers to that.
Okay, so I'll speak specifically about Bensoul.
Okay.
Bensoul is a miracle. Bensoul is one of the most talented musicians in Africa.
Yeah.
And signing Bensoul was a no-brainer because he embodies what we live for. He's a multi-talented instrumentalist. He's a vocalist. He's just a beautiful all-round person. And for us, signing Bensoul was a very short process. There was no A&R. He didn't come through. He didn't come through and like jam 7 songs and all of that.
Yeah.
For us, what we looked art is how can we take Bensoul's talent, develop it, and present it to the world. And what we really want to do right now is like look for artists who write soundtracks to people's lives, like Bensoul does, like Nyeri does, like Saudi Soul does.
Mm-hmm.
And what we're looking for right now in 2021 and looking into the future is how can we create the infrastructure that we've done and the platform that all the talented musicians in Kenya, Turkana, Nyeri, Nairobi, Meru, Embu, can come and explore their talent and express themselves.
I like that. So it's just talent?
Exactly.
And just raw talent?
Raw talent.
Yeah.
And also going beyond the raw talent. Like, how are you continuously improving yourself? Bensoul wakes up and plays guitar for an hour.
After
that, he goes for dance class. After that, he goes for voice lessons. Yeah. And it takes that level of humility to know, I am Bensoul, I'm a superstar, but I still have to rehearse.
Yeah, for sure.
Bensoul sits down with songwriters, and that's the kind of consistency, the kind of discipline. Bensoul goes to the gym, he works out, because he knows when he goes and performs at a stage, he has to be tip-top in performance. And that's the kind of raw hunger, desire, talent that we're looking for.
Oh wow!
Yeah.
Oh wow! Oh, that alone,
yeah.
that alone. You're just like, this is all that you do.
Yes, this is
music. You've made it a business. You've made it a lifestyle. You've made it's everything right now.
Yeah.
Now I don't think a lot of people knew that. They're probably, you know, Bensoul does what he does. It seems easy, but I like that. And of course, his management, because management looks at, it, like you're saying, developing and how you can go to the next level. It's thank you so much for telling us this.
Exactly. And we feel that it's really important. And we want to tell the story more and more so that when we see Bensoul out there on stage, we can appreciate what he does. And we can really like identify with him at a different level. And like for this year, more and more, we're going to be putting out more content, not just around the music, but around the creation of music, around the team that supports Bensoul and the other musicians, and also around how Bensoul can tap into the talented community in Africa.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.